Police say they're investigating the alleged assassination attempt on the vice president-elect. State broadcaster ZBC reported that the poison affected Mnangagwa's secretary as she entered the room. She was rushed to hospital for treatment. This apparently happened hours before the former justice minister was named vice president by President Robert Mugabe. Controversially, Mnangagwa was allegedly involved in the killing of some 20,000 civilians in Matabeleland in the north of the country in the mid-1980s. After his nomination as the party's and the country's vice president, Mnangagwa pledged to uphold the values of the revolution.
That I remain loyal, committed, and uphold the correct line of the revolution which we have been in for the last 52 years.
Analysts see his rise as a way to secure Mugabe's family interests. The aging president recently sidelined senior ZANU-PF officials for supporting his former deputy Joyce Mujuru, whom he accuses of wanting to assassinate him. As divisions in ZANU-PF fester, two questions need to be asked about the alleged Mnangagwa hit. Who stands to benefit? And perhaps more important, is it part of a further smear campaign to discredit opponents?